7 players from the 2019 NBA draft that have gone underrated. This is a video that I want to look back on and be like, sweet, I got one or two of these picks right. I don't want to choose players that were in the top 10 because I feel like it's easy to say, yeah, I think Cam Reddish will be a star player when only last year he was projected a top 3 pick. Like, these are players who are not typically talked about. These guys may not be superstars like Zion Williamson, Ja Morant, and RJ Barrett could turn out to be. These are the guys that are underrated because I think that they will be better than what their draft picks suggest that they will be. Hopefully you guys understand that. But also, a lot depends on how these players play, the system that they are put into, the minutes that they receive, and the team that ultimately maximizes how well they play. A lot of these players' futures honestly depend on which team they get drafted to. If you enjoy these videos, be sure to leave a like for the next video, and let's see if we can hit 1,000 likes for the next video tomorrow. Anyway, without further ado, let's get into it.
Tyler is like probably the most underrated player in our class. He's a very smooth and skilled scorer that I feel like he goes unnoticed for sometimes.
At pick 13, the Miami Heat selected Tyler Herro, a guy who hadn't really received as much hype as some of the other guys that were drafted in the lottery. But believe me, he'll be a guy that we can look back on and say, wow, how did he fall to number 13? In my opinion, keep in mind, this is all my opinion, but let me know your opinions in the comment section below. This is a kid that has been compared to Devin Booker, and that is a big comparison to live up to, because obviously Devin Booker is one of the best offensive talents in the league at the moment, even through his early stages of his career. But with the Miami Heat going through a transitional phase, with their young core of Justice Winslow, Bam Adebayo, and now Tyler Herro, he may be a guy to advance the Miami Heat to the next stage of their retool. Whilst the comparisons to Booker are there, Booker himself has stated, and I quote, "The only kid that I've watched kind of closely is Tyler Herro from Kentucky." Booker said, "I've kept in contact with him a little bit through everything he's been through this season, and he's locked in right now. So we've sort of had short conversations and look forward to see how he plays in the tournament." And Tyler Herro in the March Madness tournament was just one game away from making the Final Four at Kentucky. Literally this close, one shot away. So this guy is a guy that's proven himself as a winner already, and a guy that has actually grown a lot in the matter of 1 year with Kentucky and his basketball coach John Calipari. And Calipari said, whilst initially serving most as an off-ball scoring option early on this season, Herro has developed into a secondary ball handler for the Wildcats, and he's seen his assist numbers steadily rise throughout this year. And this is something that the Miami Heat really need. They need a secondary ball handler, considering they tried Winslow at the one, they've tried Josh Richardson at the one, and he's a great spot-up shooter. In addition to a great ball handler, he's going to fit very well with the Miami Heat, and that is the reason they drafted him. Now, I may be a little bit biased here, as I am a Miami Heat fan, but I'm not trying to be biased at all. I really do think he'll be an underrated pick for many years to come. If you would like me to further talk about why I do believe this, and solely why I think Tyler Herro could be a future All-Star, let me know in the comment section below, because I really want to make that video, but I'm not sure if you guys want to see it. Number 2, Jalen Lecque. Whilst undrafted, this gives Lecque the power to prove his doubters wrong. The Phoenix Suns made some questionable moves on draft night by ultimately trading TJ Warren, pick 6, pick 32 for Cameron Johnson and Dario Saric. In principle, they did terribly. We can never predict what happens in the future. Maybe at this point, the trade looks terrible, but if they get Lecque, who turns out to be good, if Cameron Johnson turns out to be good, we may look at this and be like, okay, well, maybe it wasn't that bad. So in principle, it doesn't look great, but who knows what happens from here. Maybe picking up Jalen Lecque and freeing up cap space for a possible free agent will change my mind about what the Phoenix Suns did on draft night, but as of now, I still can't believe what they did. But we all know why I think that. I believe that Jalen Lecque will be a great fit with the Phoenix Suns, as they obviously are in need of a point guard, and he's a guy that is a good size for a point guard in the league. The good news is that he's only 19 years old, is a 6'3 athletic point guard with a 6'7 wingspan who is highly explosive, and he has great hang time. He's able to attack the basket and can definitely challenge big men at the rim, and he can yam it down. I mean, just look at his highlights. Which is a guy that Booker can definitely play off. I don't believe he'll be a crazy player in this league in terms of stats, but he's a guy who has the potential just to be a solid starter. A guy that will have freaky highlights. A guy that we can look back on and be like, how did he get undrafted? Kind of like Fred VanVleet, but not the same player. With two guaranteed years on his deal, Lecque will have plenty of time to develop to the big level and showcase some of his raw athleticism that made him a five-star recruit in the first place. So let's see what he can do in the league. Don't sleep on Lecque. Number 3, Jalen Hands. Hands was selected by the Clippers in the second round of the 2019 NBA draft with the 56th overall pick, but then later traded to the Brooklyn Nets along with a 2020 first round pick. Jalen Hands was mostly a point guard, but played actually quite well at shooting guard too at Westwood. The 20-year-old from San Diego averaged 14.2 points per game, 6.1 assists, and 3.7 rebounds, shooting 37.3% from 3. On the other hand, he averaged 3.2 turnovers in only 31 minutes. But turnovers don't mean that you shouldn't get drafted. I mean, just look at Ja Morant, number 2 overall pick. Jalen Hands is a guy that came out of high school and had comparisons to some of the greatest basketball players ever. And I'm not kidding, ever. Which is a little bit unfortunate, but just shows why you can't compare high schoolers to NBA legends. But besides that, if you guys thought that Jalen Lecque was explosive, then Jalen Hands is on another level. This guy is insane. I remember watching his high school mixtapes and I was like, what the hell? This guy better be top 5. He didn't fall top 5. In fact, he didn't even fall in the first round. But I wish nothing but the best for him, and I hope that he kills the Clippers next time he plays them, just for saying, why did you guys let me go? I think he'll be a solid starter in this league, and I think in the long run, he'll be a solid pro. Number 4, Bruno Fernando. This is a guy that not many people talked about, and I believe he's a consistent double-double in the NBA, just as he was in college. He averaged 13.6 points, 10.3 rebounds, and added in nearly 2 blocks per game last season at Maryland. He also came one basket away from the Sweet 16. He's reasonably new to the game as he's from Angola and he only started playing late. He's the first team All-Big Ten in 2019. He's a Big Ten All-Defensive Team in 2019. And he's a Big Ten All-Freshman Team in 2018. And I believe the Hawks got a steal with this guy. I knew about him last year and I thought he looked great, and then I stopped paying attention to him and I found out when watching this year's draft that he was picked in the second round at 34 and then traded to the Atlanta Hawks. And personally, I think that he could come out as the best center in this NBA draft. Now that's a big call. At number 5, Bol Bol. But honestly, I don't know where Bol Bol is going to end up playing in the NBA. I don't know what he's going to do. And I've already talked quite a lot about him. Obviously, if you guys watch my NBA draft prediction video and you watch my NBA winners and losers video, you guys know what I think about Bol Bol. So I'm not going to get into it too much. But all I'm going to say is this guy has the highest potential out of anyone on this list. And honestly, maybe out of anybody in the NBA draft as a whole. He has the potential to prove to everyone why he should have been picked earlier and why he was not an underrated pick in this year's NBA draft, and why the Miami Heat should not have got rid of him. Come on, Miami, what are you doing? Anyway, number 6, Kevin Porter Jr. Since the start of the 2018-19 season, Porter was projected as a first round prospect for the 2019 NBA draft. Some had him top 50, others had him top 20, some even had him as high as the top 10 pick. But he ended up falling to the Bucks at pick 30, and then he was traded to the Cleveland Cavaliers. The Cavs got a steal in my opinion. He's a guy who looks up to James Harden. I'm not saying he's a player like James Harden, but he's a guy who looks up to James Harden, as both players are left-handed and share some similar traits. Personally, to me, I don't think they really play alike at all. I feel like Kevin Porter is quite athletic and Harden has a much better jump shot, but at the end of the day, if that's who he compares himself to, and that's who he looks up to, it's not a bad player to look up to. He's a player who lacked motivation, and he had some injury troubles at the start of this season, then he got suspended indefinitely by USC for personal conduct issues, but at the end of the day, he has the talent. And he could be another example of a Gilbert Arenas type player, where he just couldn't get it together in college, but once he makes the NBA, he'll ball out if he gets the minutes and the opportunity to do so. I'm not saying he will, but I do think he could be a solid starter in the NBA. Number 7, Nasir Little. This is a guy that has the upside. He's definitely a lottery talent, but he got picked with a 25th overall pick by the Portland Trailblazers. He's a McDonald's All-American in 2018, and in that game, he won the All-American Game MVP. Then he's a Jordan Brand Classic in 2018, and in that game, he's a Jordan Brand Classic co-MVP. So he's a guy that turns up in the big moments. And honestly, he could turn out to be a stud in this league. He's an explosive 6'6" forward, a guy that has been seen to lock up players that are bigger than him, such as Zion Williamson, But he's a guy that's a little bit in the air. Once he got to North Carolina, he failed to crack the starting lineup through 36 games. But as we all know through the past, playing off the bench doesn't mean a whole lot once you get to the NBA. I mean, just ask Devin Booker or just ask Russell Westbrook. I honestly don't think he'll play that many minutes personally with the Trailblazers as they're a playoff team, but watch out in 2 to 5 years. Little could be a solo player for any team in the NBA, and I will still look out for this guy. I'm not saying he's going to be a star player in this league, but for the 25th overall pick, you never know what he could become, and he's probably an underrated player for that pick. With that said, let me know your underrated picks for the 2019 NBA draft. If you have any more, I want to hear them down below. Free agency videos are coming soon, so if you guys want to hit that subscribe button, that would be greatly appreciated, and I'm sure you guys will love the free agency videos coming up. Leave a like on this video if you enjoyed. Follow me on Instagram to keep up to date with what I get up to in my personal life, and I will see you guys in my next one. I am out. Peace.